Proverbs chapter 11, verse 17. The merciful man doeth good to his own soul, but he that is cruel troubleth his own flesh. Ladies and gentlemen, Spirit of the Lord told me to talk to you one more time about suicide. So this is part two. You know what time it is. Let's get it.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot, keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sent from there could ever reach me.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? This is Apostle Makhario coming to you all again. This is, I didn't necessarily want to do another one, but the Holy Spirit spoke to me again, and I obey the Holy Spirit, as you all know. God has been so good. There's so many things I want to tell you about. There's an update on a prophecy that I told you guys I gave to a church about a year ago, a little over a year ago now, but I'll give you guys that on another video, maybe on Thursday. So let's get into this really quickly, because this is going to be a short video. I read to you Proverbs 11 and 17, chapter 11, verse 17, where it says, the merciful man doeth good to his own soul, right? But he that is cruel troubleth his own flesh. Now, this ties into basically everything that I've been teaching you for years in regards to self-harm, cutting, and even down to tattoos and piercings and suicide. It says, a merciful man will do good to his own soul, but he that is cruel troubleth his own flesh. Now, God never wants us to be cruel, not to anyone else and not to ourselves. What are the greatest two commandments? Jesus said, all of the law and the prophets hang on these two commandments. Love thy Lord thy God and have no one that's greater than him. And then secondly, love your neighbor as yourself. Right? So a merciful person, you're going to do good to your own soul. That means you're not going to allow yourself to be tormented. You're not going to trouble yourself with thoughts that are not godly. And then it also says, but he that is cruel will trouble his own flesh. What is troubling your own flesh? It is cutting yourself, tattooing yourself up, piercing up your body, committing suicide, right? And for some of you, that it would even tie to troubling your spouse, whether it's your husband or your wife. If you love your spouse and you know that that becomes, the Bible says, the two flesh become one. Jesus said that. If you know that is the case, then why would you trouble your spouse? That's something that a cruel man would do, trouble his own flesh, because your spouse is now your flesh. So, and even in the beginning, Adam said, flesh of my flesh. But let me just go here. I'm still going to keep this video short, but it says in Genesis chapter 2, verse 23, and Adam said, this is now bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. So the Bible says, once again in Proverbs 11, the merciful man doeth good to his own soul, but he that is cruel troubleth his own flesh. So this even ties into marriage. You understand? Do you see how the Spirit of God and the Holy Spirit and how God orchestrated everything throughout the Bible to help us understand by revelation and having the Holy Spirit, his thoughts toward all things? All it takes is us studying, fasting and praying, spending time in God's presence. But we should not trouble our own flesh. So even in marriage, man, woman, you should not trouble your spouse, because the Bible says that's what a cruel person does, troubles their own flesh. Now, continuing on, so that means you won't commit suicide, okay? That's a troubling of your flesh, or even attempt to cut your own wrist or slit your wrist or slit your throat or shoot yourself or all these other things that Satan tries to get people to do so that they can go to hell. You understand? All these things, these negative thoughts, these ungodly thoughts, this depression, this suicidal spirit, all of these things come from Satan and demons, and those are tormenting thoughts. The Bible says God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7. A sound mind means that you're not troubled in your thoughts. Your mind is sound. You're at peace, ladies and gentlemen. And that's what God keeps having me get to you all, that if you're going through this depression and this suicidal spirit, you should be at peace. And that peace comes from meditating on the word of God. Isaiah 26:3, thou will keep him in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on thee. Okay? So, getting into this one last thing really quickly, because like I said, this is a short video. Spirit of the Lord brought to me, and like I said, I wasn't going to do a second part to the suicide thing. I wasn't going to do another part, at least not this quickly. But the Holy Spirit woke me up and said, do another one. I said, okay. And the Lord reminded me, the Holy Spirit reminded me of Jesus. What did Satan try to do? So when I tell you that suicide is hell and these tormenting thoughts are of the devil, look at what Satan tried to do to Jesus Christ himself. Matthew chapter 4, let's see, we'll start at verse 5. Then the devil taketh him up into the holy city and setteth him on a pinnacle of the temple. So that's the highest point of the temple, right? Verse 6, and saith unto him, if thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down, for it is written, he shall give his angels charge concerning thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. So look at what Satan tried to do to Jesus Christ. Satan tried to plant the thought of suicide in Jesus Christ's head himself, who was the Son of God. Satan tried to plant the thought of having Jesus Christ kill himself. But what did Jesus Christ do when Satan tried to plant the thought? You have to combat the thoughts of the enemy, or the seeds that are planted by the enemy, with the word of God. Jesus Christ said himself to Satan in Matthew chapter 4, verse 7. Jesus said unto him, it is written again, thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And right after that, Satan tried to take him somewhere else and do something else. But you have to look at this. Jesus Christ, first of all, Satan was using scripture out of context, which is why I teach you all to study the Bible, and I walk you all through the Bible from Old Testament to New to help you understand the true thoughts and the true thought process of Jesus Christ and God the Father and the Holy Spirit, not the lies that are being planted in these churches nowadays with a lot of this New Age teaching and this overabundance of grace message and the lies of the enemy that says this is love and all you do is love a person out of their sin. Love is also correction and rebuke. And if they're not teaching you correction and rebuke and telling you to come out of your sin, then they are lying to you and they're planting satanic thoughts in your head. And so I just wanted you all to get this, that all those thoughts of depression and self-harm and suicide, all of those thoughts are from Satan himself. That's why the Bible declares, and this is why you have to study and have the Holy Spirit and be in constant communication with God the Father and Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit and in prayer and in fasting. Because the Holy Spirit woke me up. I'm not thinking about suicide because I've never had to deal with those thoughts. I've never, that I can remember in my lifetime, ever been depressed, or at least not down to the point where I didn't want to get up and do anything with my life. I've never been there personally. So God, you have to be in communication with God. And in doing so, you'll realize that Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Jesus Christ never said, I'm the way, the truth, and the suicide. I'm the way, the truth, and the death. I'm the way, the truth, and the harm yourself. Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, which means he wants you to live. Any of those suicidal thoughts and depression, anxiety, fear, worry, all of those things come from Satan. That is not of God. And if Satan took Jesus up and tried to plant the thought of suicide in Jesus' head, don't assume that you're any greater. The thoughts of suicide are not of God. That is Satan's plan to get you into hell. So I rebuke the spirit of suicide out of your life in the name of Jesus. I decree and declare that you are set free. Continue to watch these videos, because this is how you get free, by hearing the true word of God. The Bible says, so then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God in Romans chapter 10, verse 17. So I love you all. You have to hear the true word of God, the word of God in truth, not the way that a lot of places teach it with the lies that you'll be fine. And I have people that claim to be Christian that say to themselves, when I brought this up and I told you all this in part one of suicide, but they said that if a person commits suicide and they're a Christian, they're going to go to heaven. I said, that's not scriptural. It's not written in the Bible anywhere. They will end up in hell. So faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Romans chapter 10, verse 17. Subscribe to this channel so that you could get the true word of God and grow and get out of those satanic planted seeds and thoughts that are in your head that God does not want to bless you. He wants to bless you, but you have to come out of your sin. You have to come out of the things that are causing you to be tormented in your thoughts, which is caused by condemnation from your sin in most cases. Now, in the case of Jesus Christ, he was just coming off of a fast, and Satan tried to get him at his weakest point. And that's what Satan will do when he plants those thoughts of depression and suicide. Satan wants to get you while you're at your weakest point and say, hey, nobody cares about you. You have no reason to live. Nobody would care if you weren't here anymore. Well, that is a lie from the pit of hell. That is a lie from the enemy. That is a lie from Satan. God has a purpose and a reason for your life. Remember, I told you, it says in Acts 15, 18, known unto God are all his works from the beginning of the world. God knew that he had you here for a reason. He knew why he brought you here for this time. He knew the situation that you would be nurtured in, and he wants you to be free and to grow stronger in him. That way you can overcome all of these things. I love you all. I will see you all again soon. I am praying for you. Don't forget to subscribe. It is so important to hear the truth of the gospel. I'm telling you, you cannot make it in this life without hearing the truth of the gospel, without hearing the voice of God, without hearing the voice of Jesus Christ, without being in tune with the Holy Spirit. God wants you to prosper. 3 John 2, beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. So that ties in again to what I just gave you all in the beginning, which is in Proverbs chapter 11, verse 17. The merciful man doeth good to his own soul, but he that is cruel troubleth his own flesh. What did 3 John 2 say? Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. So the more that your soul prospers from hearing the true word of God, the more that you will prosper and be in good health. I love you all. I love you, Jesus. I will see you all again soon. May God bless, and we are out.
Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me? Heaven's above me, hell is beneath me. How in the world could these devils ever defeat me?
Accepting the fact that my goal is the top, then knowing heaven is in that spot keeps driving me nonstop. Never allowing hell to defeat me. It's not possible as long as it's beneath me. Nothing sin from there could ever reach me.